begin this Mass by asking mercy and forgiveness for our sins so that we can worthily celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord, you're sent to heal the contrite. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to Christ sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who are glorified in the Bishop St. Martin, both by his life and death, make new, we pray, the wonders of your grace in our hearts, that neither death nor life may separate us from your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Responsorial Psalm, the Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful waters he leads me, he refreshes my soul.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
He guides me in right paths. For his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side with your rod and your staff that give me courage.
The Lord is my shepherd, and there is nothing I shall want.
You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my cup with oil. My cup overflows.
The Lord is my shepherd.
Samaria and Galilee. As he was entering a village, 10 lepers met him. They stood at a distance from him and raised their voices, saying, "Jesus, Master, have pity on us." When he saw them, he said, "Go show yourselves to the priests." As they were going, they were cleansed. And one of them, realizing he had been healed, returned, glorifying God in a loud voice. And he fell at the feet of Jesus and thanked him. He was a Samaritan. Jesus said in reply, 10 were cleansed, were they not? Where are the other 9? Has none but this foreigner returned to give thanks to God?" Then he said to him, "Stand up and go. Your faith has saved you." My sisters and brothers, this is the good news, the gospel of the Lord. Guys, about 6 or 7 of them lined up in their dress blues, standing around. have a specific book on the subject, and you do have a copy of the documents of Vatican II, go to the index, look up baptism, and then open it up and read everything that the church says about it. That was the day we first experienced salvation. But how many of us ever say thank you to God? In this gospel passage today, I think it's a very interesting story. In the ancient world, they didn't know where leprosy came from. All they knew was it was fatal, and there was no cure. That's why lepers were ostracized from the community. They could not live in the community of the village or the city. That's why they had to stay together. That's why people stayed away from them. And I can just imagine, I don't know if this is true, but I can imagine, as Jesus is entering this village, surrounded by a crowd of his disciples, and these 10 lepers appear, I can imagine the crowd kind of shying away from Jesus and from these 10 lepers. And he cured them. And they went off to show themselves to the priest. That would be the ultimate proof that they were cured. And as they were going, they realized they had been cleansed. And of the 10, only one came back to say thank you, glorifying God. And as the gospel says, he was a Samaritan. The Samaritans were despised by the Jews. The Samaritans were the descendants of those people who had been conquered by the kingdom of Assyria, who had intermarried with the people the Assyrians brought in, pagans, and had developed a mixed religion. It was part Jewish and part pagan. And they were despised. No observant Jew could even set foot in Samaria. And here Jesus walked right through the place on his way to Jerusalem. So for the Jewish readers of this gospel passage, it would have caused maybe a moment of shock that a Samaritan, of all people, like, what about the other nine? Maybe they were observant Jews. What about them? How come they didn't come back and say thank you? But only this person did. Our saint today, as Father Mark said, St. Martin of Tours, lived in the 4th century. He was a soldier. He served in the Roman army. The bio I looked at says he became a catechumen. There was an order in the church. He became a catechumen at the age of 10, not yet baptized. Then, ultimately, he went into the Roman army. I don't know whether he was an officer or a regular soldier. But there is a story about him that as
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Sanctify these offerings, we pray, O Lord, which we joyfully present in honor of Saint Martin, so that through them our life may always be directed, whether in tribulation or in prosperity, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of Saint Martin you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, As we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May you make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, your blessed spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, Saint Martin of Tours, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Myron, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. Dear, we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, power, and glory of yours, come forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
Hmm. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
have a theme relating to the Eucharist. It's so important that people come back to the table of the Eucharist because after the pandemic, everyone will return because we are nourished and strengthened and become church by means of the Eucharist. Please join Father Joe this evening as he prepares us, prepares the way.